What's going on, y'all? Taylor Ware back again with another video. Today is a kind of hard video to make, but I'm gonna put it out there. My experience as a Southwest International parts delivery driver. Yeah, I was a parts guy. I was delivering parts for International. Before I got my CDL, they kind of were the ones that really wake me up to the whole CDL industry. It kind of got me to look at the what the owner operators deal with, because I got to meet a lot of them and to go talk to a bunch of them. I got a lot of experience working at the parts industry, you know, so because I got to see exactly what it takes to really kind of what it takes to be owner operator and how these parts go and stuff like that. I even got to meet a lot of the sales guys. So the sales guys were real cool, was there, but I was just a parts delivery driver, so I kind of learned some parts too. But anyways, the moral of the story today is it's going to be really stupid, so just don't laugh at me. But I mean, it's not stupid, it's just kind of a personal experience. So I worked for them back in 2019, and as a parts guy, parts delivery guy. So pretty much I was doing good. We would go to like different truck stops, different trucking companies, different truck part distribution warehouses, and deliver and pick up different truck stuff. And you know, that's what the job was. I drove a box truck, a straight truck, nothing too fancy, whatever, it is what it is. So it was about, at that store, it was probably about four of us, right? And I had the east side of everything, like East Dallas, stuff like that, East Fort Worth. And I did pretty much the loop. You know, it wasn't really a hard job. You know, it wasn't hard at all. It was pretty easy. But I got hard on there. I was doing good at first, doing pretty good. Towards the end of the career that I had, the end of my experience with them, I was dealing with some personal stuff. And I was dealing with some personal issues. I'm not going to go too deep into my personal issues, but I was dealing with some personal issues and stuff. So any of you guys, you know, I want y'all to, and just to give anybody just a little heads up, in transportation, especially transportation, if you are dealing with any type of issues, anything personally that's kind of taking your mind away from your task at hand, stop for a little bit. Just stop. You know, just try to take a couple of days off, a week if you can. Take some time off to just think about it and reflect about things and stuff, and just to calm down, because you're not just, it's not about you when you're driving. It's about other people. So other people, you got to keep other people safe as well. You know, it can be dangerous. So back to the story, because I know me too. My mind, if I'm dealing with something at home, if I'm dealing with something personal, I don't do good in my work life. I just don't, because my mind is somewhere else and I can forget stuff. And speaking of forgetting, I'm going to tell you what's going on. First strike there, when I was there, I started to forget deliveries. Started to forget deliveries. And they would notice, I'm like, hey man, did you remember to go to such and such? And I was like, oh man, I forgot. And I was like, dang, okay, did you forget to take back? Yeah, I forgot. So that's strike number one. Strike number two, I ran out of gas. Ran out of gas. Now, I know what you're thinking. It's not just no coincidence. We were about four delivery drivers there. All of us went to the same gas station to go pick up to get the same gas around the same time every day. The only time we didn't go get gas is if we had enough gas from the day before, or we just didn't have time to go get gas. But most of the time, we all went to the same place to go get the gas every single day, every morning before we started going on our routes. That's what we did. I forgot. I just forgot. I'm telling you, man, you know, my mind was just out there. I'm going to go ahead and kind of give a little hint, whatever y'all might be thinking. It was a woman problem. It was a woman problem. I'm not going to go too deep in it, but y'all know how they can be. And I'm just gone. I'm just like, and she just, you know, Big Sean say, holding my mind for ransom. My mind is just out of there. So, yeah, anyways, fast forward or whatever. That's third absolute strike. My supervisor came to me that morning. Said, hey, Taylor, man, what's going on? Anything going on with you personally? Like I'm hearing your name in the office a lot. You know, you've been getting deliveries. We done had to send out a truck, you know, and the truck that they had to do to fill me up with gas, because the gas was blinking all day. Like, that day, I'm playing music, but my mind is just somewhere else, right? My mind is just gone. I'm on 30. I'm on a highway. It just a doop, 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 doop. And I'm like, oh, what the heck going on? So I pull over, and it's out of gas. So they had to send Penske out there to come and fill me up again. Because in a box truck, it ain't just no can that you could just go buy at the store down the street and make it to the gas station. No, you got to have a big, giant can for that. So they spent at least probably $500 just for them to come and get me some gas so I can keep going to the gas station itself. So, of course, they was pissed. But the supervisor come to me and was like, hey, man, I'm hearing your name in the office a lot. Like, what's going on? Anything going on personally? You wouldn't been doing this before. You was a good worker. How about this and that? And I'm like, nah, everything good. Lying, you know. At that moment, what he came to me and said, he was like, hey, man, if you need any time off, it's just cool. Just say something. If something's going on, you ain't got to tell me, but just say something. That was my opportunity, but I don't usually like to talk about my stuff going on. But I did, you know, I didn't say anything. So I was like, it's okay. After he said that, I'm mad because my emotions is going crazy and stuff like that. You know, we ain't supposed to have emotions and all this stuff like that, but it is what it is. My mind gone and stuff like that. And just, it's just crazy stuff. So after that, I'm like, who talking about me in the office? I'm pissed off and mad about that. Da-da-da, this and that, this. And I'm the best driver here. Whatever. I bag into a truck, a semi-truck, in the parking lot. How dumb can you be? Southwest International buys and sells trucks. They fix on trucks as well. One of the mechanics was fixing on a truck, and I bagged into the truck. They probably just got done fixing it. I bagged into it. I can laugh about it now, but at that time, man, I was messed up, man. I don't know what I was thinking. So, supervisor came. He didn't even make it in the building good. Everybody came out like, oh, he's done. Hey, man, I'm glad to let you go. I was like, well, I understand. Ain't nothing I can do. So, that's that story, y'all. That's the story. That was my experience as a Southwest International parcel delivery guy. You know, anybody that's wanting to do that type of work is cool, especially if you want to get in the trucking industry. You should do that. It was a good job. I messed it up. They paid decent. Not gonna say it paid a lot, but they paid decent. And it gave you the experience. Because that's what jobs are for. They're not just some job. They're experiences. There's something to put on your belt and something to be like, I learned from this. I did that. I did even learn. And one main thing I did learn was, if I'm going through something personally, we all go through stuff. Take some time away. Make sure you save your money so you can pay all your bills or whatever you got to do. But for times like these, because they gonna come, save your money, do what you gotta do, take time off. If something's going on where you know you cannot function well, take the time off. You know, just take the time off. That's what I should have did. But hey, it is what it is. And matter of fact, just to make long story short, it was on my record too. You know, it was. Like, so I have to explain that today. You know, like, what happened? And I have to explain and tell them why. So, yeah, I just want y'all to know that, man. This is just a little video I wanted to put out there. Anybody that's interested in doing parcel delivery or parcel salesman, man, it's a good career. Get into sales. If you're going to do parts, get into selling parts. Don't just be a delivery driver. Sell the parts. You know, so that's all my little advice about that. So this is it. That's all I got for y'all today. I just wanted to, you know, put out that story real quick. So give me a like, give me a dislike, whatever you want to do, whatever. Leave a comment, talk to me, tell me about it, whatever. So I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.